no, there's no need for me to create an ailing and link at businesses with any closure. They are going to suffer from not being able to recognize what is happening within this economy.
There's been a lot of silence from the minister. Are you doing anywhere?
Oh, yes, yes, there's been a lot of silence. We've now recognized that the future of the Zimbabwean economy lies in the indigenous people of Zimbabwe. And to that end, what we've been doing is we've been establishing our frameworks for us to effectively grow our own economy. For example, we have our youth officers identified over 39,358 young entrepreneurs that have created a total of over 93,000 jobs. More jobs than have been created by foreign direct investment. So our focus now is on the real players in the economy, on the people that really will determine the future of the economy.
But the Zimbabwe stock exchange is suffering right now. Companies are delisting, because it's delisting. Does this have anything to do with the indigenization policy?
No, it has got a lot to do with the companies that have failed to transition from the colonial economy of Rhodesia into the more inclusive economy of Zimbabwe. You now find that those companies have not been able to recognize the transition that Zimbabwean economy is going through. And as a result, my brother, you are now actually giving further evidence to my thesis that if we don't reform, and if those companies don't reform within the context of the changing dynamics of the Zimbabwean economy, they will become extinct. And this is what you see with Mikkels. And you must remember that the Mikkels group has its origins from the chairman of the Loot Committee. It was a company that was built on looting the resources of indigenous Zimbabweans.
So basically, you are just letting them die down. You're not going to take action as you threatened before.
We've always tried to educate those that do not see. But at a certain point, you then want to be able to say, well, look, if they cannot see, what can you do? This is a free country. They are free to be blinkered. They are free to be visionless. And they are free to actually waste away their investors' resources.
There are some who say that during the time that you were threatening to close up companies, almost 2 billion in capital fled the country.
That is nonsensical. It is not correct. That is nonsensical.
Some say that that's the time when we started having a liquidity crunch and putting it on the...
Those are people that really have got no understanding of economics.
So what really caused this?
There is a minister responsible for finance and economic development. I am an economist in my own right, so I will be able to explain to you what has been happening within the Zimbabwean economy. But if you look at what the Minister of Finance has said, and if you look at what the governor of the Reserve Bank has said, they've indicated to you aspects of externalization. One of the monetary policy statements that came from the government indicated a figure of $1.8 billion that was externalized. And if you look at what the Minister of Industry and Commerce has done with regards to statutory instrument 64, it will then show you that what we have had to do as a government is to recognize that the future of the economy lies in production within the economy. And also, if you look at the most recent figures in terms of trade, you will also realize that the amount of imports has reduced as a result of statutory instrument 64. Now, I'm expecting you, if you are a good journalist, to report on the facts, not to report on the opinions of clueless nincompoops.
But at one point you had a tiff between you and the RZZ governor and
I never had, no, I never had a tiff.
I
never had a tiff with anyone, my brother. You can't put a tiff on me. No, I never had a tiff with anyone.
But I
work well with the Minister of Finance, and I want to be able to tell you that the Minister of Finance is supporting the establishment of Empowerment, and you saw that in his monetary policy statement. You saw that in his budget statement. now? Where are you getting a tip?
Okay, maybe you had a healthy debate. You had a healthy debate with the minister. The minister issuing statements, you issuing statements that were contradictory at that particular time.
But what you have, my brother, is General Notice Number 9 of 2016, which was as a result of the work that we were doing together, and that was issued in January of 2016.
But you then ended up saying that you had misinterpreted the law, and now you
understand. No. I did not misinterpret the law. At no point did I misinterpret the law. And you want to be able to... You see, there are these people that want to take out a narrative in which you misinterpreted the law. And yet they cannot cite which section I misinterpreted and how I misinterpreted it. My brother, I interpreted the law properly and accurately.
So why did the His Excellency to issue a statement?
His Excellency's statement was very clear. It says there are various misinterpretations of the Indigenization Act.
And that was the truth.
Yes, that was not me. Because I know for a fact that there is no section that I misinterpreted. So if you have anything to be able to say, Joao misinterpreted this section, please set out the section. Otherwise, no more.